All right, well, welcome back for the second time.
We apologize for technical difficulties.
What was a very great broadcast that no one heard but the three people around me at the moment. This is going to be Jacoby Coles has it at the top of the key. Horned Frogs are up 23-16 with 13 minutes and 49 seconds left to go in the first half. Avery Anderson gives it off. It's going to be Jameer Nelson. He's guarded by Jizzle James. Four off the shot clock. He puts up a three-pointer. It's no good. It's nothing but air. Air ball out of bounds, Bearcats ball.
To kind of catch you up on everything that's happened so far, TCU has come out the gate swinging. They lead 23-16, just over 6 minutes into the game. TCU's forced three turnovers already for the Bearcats. We knew coming into the game they would. Bearcats with the ball now. Foul will be called on TCU, but we knew that this would be a fast game coming in, and it's lived up to the hype.
Good summary to catch the people up. You know, as you mentioned, we were, the first 5 minutes, we were in a shootout. I mean, it was actually kind of crazy how much offense we were seeing. TCU at a point was 8-for-8 in their last field goals, and now that air ball is their first miss in 9 shots. This is going to be no call. Going up with it was Oguama, but no call. Fast break for the Horned Frogs. Miller drives in, guarded by Lukacs, gives it off. This is going to be Coles for three, and it's good. Nothing but net. Jacoby Coles gives the Horned Frogs a 10-point lead, 26-16. Here in the first half, Lukacs has it. And the left wing gives off the band to go. Who came off the bench today? Jizzle James is going to drive in, guarded by Avery Anderson, gives it off to Newman, who gives it off. They swing it around to Lukacs, who's going to drive in, band to go at the post. Newman thought about it. Could have had a chance for open three, but decided not to do it. He's going to drive in, gets it off to Jizzle, and it's a bad pass. And it'll be another turnover for the Bearcats, number 5 in the game so far.
A tight and aggressive D so far from the Horned Frogs, just continuing on that drive.
Horned Frogs have 4 steals already, a team that averages 10 steals per game, which is 11th nationally. Fury defense is what they are, and what they consist of. Avery Anderson has it as he crosses half court. 12:48 left to go in the first half. Gets a screen by Nelson. Underneath, great pass to Coles. Out of bounds, and it's going the other way. Bearcats ball. TCU shooting 10 for 12 from the field so far, including 5 of 7 beyond the arc. Jizzle James has it. He's going to give it to Oguama. Bearcats running a big lineup with Oguama, Lukacs, and Bandigo. Lukacs, 3-point from the white ring is up, and it's no good, and a foul is called. Looks like it's going to be on Oguama. Chuck O'Bannon drew the foul.
Ball gets
Horned Frogs ball.
Ball gets stuck on top of the basket there.
So who will be the hero to get this ball out? Okay, we have someone who has a mop who gives it off to Nelson. Nelson looks, jumps, hits it, and it comes out unloose, and we resume play. And the crowd boos Nelson for doing the right thing. Not the ideal reaction.
Shout out the ball boy providing the mop.
Clutch play right there. We had some unusual activity. You know, ball gets stuck.
Won't goes into the score sheet, but he's saved the day.
As he mops the area, getting the sweat out. Okay, for real. Avery Anderson has it, guarded by Skillings. He gets tackled by the crowd. One of the TCU players is going to be Junior Nelson. He has it. He's going to drive in, stops at the top of the key. Jefferson gives it off to Avery Anderson, guarded by Skillings, pull-up jumper, and that's blocked by Skillings. Fast break for the Bearcats. Here we go. Jizzle James drives in, layup is up, and it's blocked by Avery Anderson to third. Oh, my goodness.
Avery Anderson making his presence known. Got up as high as the rim, knocked it away.
And a foul's going to be called on Jizzle James with the driving Jameer Nelson. 11:50 left to go in the first half. Horned Frogs up 26-16. We'll be right.
Welcome back, folks, to 90s night here at Fifth Third Arena. We have a little substitution here in the booth. Aiden Riggs takes off a headset and gets it to Henry Meiderding. Welcome on, Henry.
Hey, everybody. I'm glad to be here. Fantastic night tonight, 90s night. It's a great theme. I love it.
So Bearcats are up. Excuse me, they trail 26-16. This is going to be Micah Peavy has it top of the key, guarded by Josh Reed. 12 left on the play clock. Underneath, this is going to be Peavy. Pump fakes, drives in layup, but it's blocked by Bandigo. 5 seconds left, scrap for the ball. This is going to be Jacoby Cole, gives it off to Mustafa. Layup is no good off the glass. Rebound, it ends up in the hands of Jizzle James.
And the Bearcats all around the bottom of the basket there ended up with the rebound.
It's going to be Reed at the left wing, has it, gives off the Skillings. Skillings gives it the lock in the top of the key, gives it to Jizzle James, gets a screen. Jizzle thought about it, so a cross-court pass to Skilling. Court three is up, no good. Rebounded by Jacoby Cole. Horned Frogs have it. Avery Anderson directing traffic. Gets a sign from Coach Jamie Dixon. 17 left on the play clock. Goes to the left side of the wing. Guarded by Jizzle James. Gets a screen. He's going to go to the right side. It's going to be Peavy underneath. This is going to be Mustafa, guarded by Bandigo. Nothing's falling there. This is going to be Jacoby Cole driving in, guarded by Lock and step back. Jumper is up. No good. Rebounded by Josh Reed. Reed crosses half court. Jizzle James gets a play call from Wes Miller. 10:28 left to go in the first half. James hits a screen by Locken. He gives off the Skilling's top of the key. Skilling's going to drive in. Thought about it. Throws up the layup, but it's an air ball. Horned Frogs have it. This is going to be Travian Tennyson. Gives it off in the corner of the PV, guarded by Locken. He's going to drive it on Locken. Spin move, fading away, jumper is no good. Rebounded by Bandigan. James has it at the right wing. Gives the Bandigan underneath the Locken, and that one airmails, and it sails out of bounds. Another turnover for the Bearcats.
And the right idea, wrong execution there on that play. Locken down low, had the size advantage, but the pass just went over his head and out of bounds.
So in the game that started off as a shootout, now it's stalled into a barn burner. The Bearcats are in a scoring drought over 4 minutes, and the Horned Frogs are in a scoring drought over 3 minutes.
Yeah, a big part of that has to do with the Bearcats' defense on the perimeter. Their offense hasn't been able to click, but they've been doing a lot better on defense, not allowing the three balls to go up.
You trade one thing for another. Avery Anderson crosses half court, gives it to Emmanuel Miller, the senior who's averaging 17 points a game for the Horned Frogs. Anderson falls with it. He gives it to Miller, top of the key. Horned Frogs working it around. This is going to be Peavy, layup, pass it up. He's going to give it to Travian Tennyson. That one is no good. Looks like Peavy potentially had a layup and pass it up for a three ball to Tennyson. Josh Reed, pump fakes, gives it off to Reynolds, who gives it off to Day-Day Thomas, who's double-teamed. That ball is stolen, but a foul is called. Foul called on Avery Anderson III, the senior from Justin, Texas.
Yeah, and the foul called there, but TCU has been playing this scrappy defense the whole game that has only given up 16 points. It's putting some pressure on the Bearcats thus far.
Bearcats facing a little adversity, the tough defense by the Horned Frogs. Anderson checks out, and checking in was Uday, I believe. Skillings has the top of the key, 10 seconds left on the play clock. He gives off the read in the right wing underneath to Reynolds. That ball's poked away, and it's stolen once again. Emmanuel Miller gives it off to Jameer Nelson, gives it to Travian Tennyson. 20 left on the play clock. Miller gets it again. At the right wing, right on the Fifth Third logo, gives it to Uday. Top of the key, that ball's poked away, but ends up in the hands of the Horned Frogs. 10 seconds left. Working on Reynolds. That's going to be Nelson. His jumper's no good. There's going to be a fight for it. It's going to be a jump ball. That's going to be Bearcats basketball. Day-Day Thomas forces the jump with the 6'11 center, Ernest Uday.
Yeah, and this scoring drought just continues on both ends. The Bearcats now 5 minutes 41 seconds without a basket. The Horned Frogs 4 minutes 44 seconds without theirs. The court is getting dry out here.
Bearcats have 4 turnovers in the last 6 minutes. They have 7 on the night compared to the Horned Frogs' 1 turnover.
I'll tell you what, if you like defense, this is the basketball game for you.
Day Thomas has the top of the key. He's going to drive in. Step back jumper is up. And the scoring drought is over. Day Thomas finally gives us something to cheer about here at Fifth Third Arena. And the offensive means. This is going to be Miller has it. Swings at the Peavy. He gives it to Tennyson in the corner. Uday has it the right wing. Gives it to Miller. Guarded by the lock in. Horned Frogs working it around. Nelson has it, receives air ball chance from the Ruckus. That ball's poked away. Fast break from the Bearcats. Thomas gives it the read. His three-pointer is up. He lets it fly, and he misses everything on it. And a foul is going to be caught on Jameel Reynolds. As it looks like Jameer Nelson might have took a shot to the face. Bearcats trail 26-18 with 7:46 left to go in the first half. Henry. I understand it's been more of a slugfest the past 7 minutes and a whole shootout in the first 6 minutes of the game, but so far, what is standing out to you on the court?
From the Bearcats, perimeter defense has picked up, as I stated earlier, but also post defense. Forcing turnovers has been big for them in previous games and starting to come to life here. But yeah, definitely a lack of scoring, to say the least. The Bearcats have been struggling. TCU's been struggling. We just finally got that basket on this end, I believe, from Day Thomas. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I think since I put on this headset here, only 2 points have been scored, and I think that's coming from the Bearcats now with 18 points at the 7:46 mark here in the game.
And you mentioned the defense the Bearcats have been playing that's slowed down this Fury TCU offense so far. The Bearcats have held top 15 opponents, BYU and Baylor, to their season lows this season. Both on the road and 30 and 25 points below their respective season averages entering that night.
Yeah, and I think that's been a big part as to why the Bearcats have hit the ground running here in Big 12 play. They got their first win out in Utah against BYU. And then they play 2 very close games to follow that. And if anything, no one can take it away from the Bearcats that they belong. Their last couple games have come down to poor coaching decisions, a couple ISO plays, and, of course, free throws. If you've been anywhere on social media, you've seen how upset the fans have been about that. So just minor fundamental errors on the Bearcats' end that could have had those games going the other way. But certainly happy to be where we are right now. And I think that the team is just getting better and better, as I've seen throughout those last 3 games. They're a young team. A lot of transfers and young guys who are trying to glue the team together. And I think that opening up here, they've now played 4 ranked opponents, and they'll be at 6 if things go the way they're supposed to right now. It's good for these young guys and these transfers to get that kind of veteranship under their belt before we get deeper into the season.
You mentioned free throws being criticized on social media. The Bearcats shoot 68% from the charity stripe as a team, which is 12th in the Big 12. When you look at the Horned Frogs, they shoot 73% from the charity stripe. But the Horned Frogs are one of the hotter teams in all of America. You know, they're coming off consecutive wins over AP top 10 teams for the second time in program history. They defeated the 9th ranked Sooners and the 2nd ranked Cougars.
Yeah, they've had one of the best 2024s across college basketball. I think their only loss comes to Kansas, and that was a 2-point loss. Kansas currently ranked 3rd in the nation. For those not keeping up, they're a good basketball program. So it's a proud loss to lose by 2 to them.
Emmanuel Miller, the forward, reigning Big 12 Player of the Week, is averaging 20 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists over the week. A 3-pointer lets it fly by Travian Tennyson, gives the Horned Frogs an 11-point lead. Bandigo has it, gives off to Lukasic. He's going to drive in, hesitate, stop at the baseline. Gives off to Newman. They're going to reset. Day Thomas has it. Double team guard. He gives off to Bandigo, top of the key. Gives it to Lukasic at the left. Lukasic, 10 seconds, guarded by Miller. Gives it off to Day Thomas. He's going to drive in, pull up, jumper is up, and it's no good. Deytowns gets his own rebound, though. Layup is up, takes a contact, banks it in. No foul is called, but Danny Thomas, a nice shot off the glass to cut the lead to 9.
Yeah, and he took that one right to the center. Drew some contact. The fans may be arguing for a foul. Didn't get it there.
In the corner, Miller has it guarded by Newman. Avery Anderson drives in, loses it, and this will stay Horned Frogs basketball. Fans thought maybe should be Bearcats basketball, but it stays at the other end of the court. Inbounded to Uday. Gives it back to Anderson, guarded by Skillings in the corner. This is going to be Tennyson. Another three-pointer is up, rims it. Rebound corralled by Newman. Fast break. Skillings, he's going to rise up. Reverse layup is no good. And now the Horned Frogs have a fast break, but he loses it. And a foul is called on Micah Peavy on the driving Day-Day Thomas.
Yeah, and on that last one, we saw Skillings go up, and he kind of put up this little circus shot almost, and it didn't go. That's usually one of the guys that you're more confident with in taking it to the rim. But there, he seemed to try something that doesn't always work. He's fortunate that the Bearcats got the steal on the following play.
Last Tuesday, we saw Skillings do the same exact thing, but instead he threw down the poster over Tyrese Hunter, made on the SportsCenter top 10, ranked at 5th. Skillings checks out. Josh Reed checks in for the Bearcats. Newman has it, gives it to Lukasz. Lukasz, top of the key, guarded by Tennyson. He's going to work on him, drives in, throws it off, and it's no good. Ends up in the hands of the Horned Frogs. Avery Anderson, the third, has it, gives off to Emmanuel Miller in the corner. He lets it fly. It's no good. Rebounded by Bandigo.
And the Bearcats catching a little break here from TCU's three-point reign. Another missed shot there, but it was open.
TCU has made their only one field goal out of the last 10 as Lukasz drives in, layup off the glass is good. Bearcats now trail by 7 with 5:47 left to go, and Coach Jamie Dixon will talk it over with his squad. Bearcats trail 22-29. We'll be right back here on Bearcats Sports Radio. We welcome you back to Fifth Third Arena, where 90s night is taking place. However, there are no retro jerseys. Horned Frogs in all purple, Bearcats in all white. Avery Anderson gives it off to Cole, who gives it to Miller. 15 left on the play clock. It's going to be Avery Anderson. He's going to drive in and almost lose his footing. Pump fakes, and that ball is blocked by Bandigo, but a travel is called.
Yeah, you mentioned no throwback jerseys here tonight. That's just disgraceful. If anything, bring out the red jerseys tonight. Give the fans what they want.
During the stripeout last Tuesday against Texas, fans really enjoyed those throwback retro red jerseys, inspired, I believe, by the 2006 opener where they played in the Big East.
That's correct.
Look at me. I'm a history guy.
There you go.
Lukasz drives in, alley-oop the Bandigo, and it's nowhere to be found. Bearcats retain possession, though. Jizzle James has it, 7 left on the play clock. He's guarded by Anderson. Jizzle James is going to drive in. Gives it off to Reed. Elbow jumper is up, and it falls in. Josh Reed gets his first basket of the night, and the Horned Frogs are in a 2-minute scoring drought as Fifth Third Arena is on their feet. Cork has it, guarded by Bandigo at the top of the key. Hands it off to Avery Anderson, who gives it to... It's going to be Jacoby Cole, guarded by Lukasz in the corner. He's going to work on me in the baseline. Cole throws it up. No good. Rebounded by Josh Newman. Newman takes the contact. No foul is called. Bandigo has it. He's going to drive in. This time a foul is called. That's going to be Xavier Cork caught committing the crime. And the Bearcats will inbound it underneath the basket. Double substitution. This is going to be Chuck O'Bannon and Ernest Uday coming in for Xavier Cork and Avery Anderson along with Jacoby Coles. So Jameer Nelson also checks in too for the Horned Frogs. Reed has it in the corner. And that ball is poked up, retained possession. Lukasz has it near the fifth third logo at the right wing. That ball is stolen by Emmanuel Miller. Fast break for the Horned Frogs, goes up, misses the layup, but a putback. Ernest Uday right there to follow through. Bearcats fast break. Jizzle James has it going coast to coast. Gives it off to Newman in the corner in front of the TCU bench. Throws up the layup off the glass. It's good.
And John Newman with a great play there. He's Cincinnati's leading scorer now with 9, and he does it again there. A great spin move. Just bullies his way through the paint for the bucket.
Miller has it in front of the Bearcats bench. Gives it off to Nelson. In the hands of O'Bannon driving in. And a foul is called. Offensive foul is called. Bearcats will regain possession.
How about this? Some aggressive Big 12 basketball.
Bearcats have made their last 3 field goal attempts. And a foul. Couldn't catch who's a foul is called on Chuck O'Bannon. O'Bannon is a 7th-year player. He turns 25 in March. O'Bannon led the team in 3-pointers made the past 2 seasons. Horned Frogs are up 31-26 with 3:38 left to go in the first half.
Yeah, and for those wondering, I had to Google it sitting here. Jameer Nelson, the TCU guard, is in fact the Orlando Magic's former player, Jameer Nelson. It's his son, so basketball runs in the family with that one. I was fully intrigued. When I heard the name, I did a double take looking at the court.
And when you look at Jizzle James, son of NFL Hall of Famer Edgerrin James.
Yeah. Being a Colts fan, that one rings home for me. Indianapolis love here.
Edgerrin was here last Tuesday for the Big 12 home opener for the Bearcats. Not sure if he's here today, but never know.
Hopefully Jizzle starts playing better himself. Only 1 field goal put up, he missed it. 0 points, 1 rebound for him, and a foul in 7 minutes. It's a pretty empty stat line. You usually rely on him to have some ISO plays here and there to bring the crowd into it and the team to life, and it hasn't been there thus far. For the Bearcats, it's been the forwards. The coaches and Newman doing the work as far as the guys on the court go. Newman is 4-for-4 right now, including a 3-point make. He also has 3 rebounds, all on the defensive end. He leads the Bearcats in both points and rebounds. Day-Day Thomas leads in assists. He currently has 3.
When you mentioned John Newman shooting 4-for-4 tonight, he's been described as the heart and soul of the team. He shot 2-for-10 in his last 2 games tonight. 4-for-4 in the field.
I mean, that's what you expect from a graduate, right? A guy who's been around so long, you expect him to lead this team. Especially when you're surrounded by young guys like Dan Skillings, who we know have the ability to hoop and put on an ISO show, but when it comes to putting together leadership, that's a whole different quality that comes with time.
And when you look at Newman, he can be described as a veteran here in the college basketball world. And when you struggle offensively, you know, a veteran and a good player finds ways how to make plays in a different way, whether it's rebounding or ball handling, whatever it may be, they find ways to make plays. We're here back in action. Jizzle James has it. He's guarded by Nelson, gives it off to Skillings. Back out to James. Looks like Horned Frogs are in a zone at the moment. James, he's going to drive in. Hesitates. Spin move. Gives it off to Skillings at the right wing. Skillings, he's going to drive in. 2, layup is up. Off the glass, no good, but Locken is there with the follow through.
And that's Lockin's first bucket of the night, finally getting involved. And look at this crowd. They come to life, too.
It's going to be Uday has the top of the key. Goes off to Miller, guarded by Josh Reed. Tennyson has it, guarded by Skillings. Gets a play call from Jamie Dixon. Looks like miscommunication between Uday and Nelson. He's going to drive in, layoff high, arcing off the glass. No good, corralled by Newman. Newman looks up, Eastern Triangle, coast to coast. Has it almost stolen and ends up popped up in the air. Ends in the hands of Jizzle James. Jizzle looks cross court, Skillings, corner three. Lets it fly, and it's good. Tie game, 31 apiece.
And what a fantastic job by the Bearcats coming out of that timeout and owning every single play thus far.
Nelson has it, drives in, layup off the glass is good, and he silences the crowd here at Fifth Third Arena. 33-31, Horned Frogs lead, 2:06 left to go in the first half. Skillings gives it back out to James. Wants a screen from Lockin. James, pull up three, no good. Rebounded by Emmanuel Miller.
And there's the Cincinnati Heat check as they were 5 of 6 of their last field goals.
Nelson blocked by Lockin. He gets the ruckus hyped. Get that out of here. Ski! Ball will stay on this end of the court.
A tremendous play there from Lockin to bring the crowd back to life. We've seen him do it 100 times before. How about 101 for you?
Nelson will inbound it. 1:46 left to go, 21 seconds on the play clock, and the ruckus chance airball at Jameer Nelson for his airball attempt early in the game. Still receiving it from the ruckus. He gets the ball. It's guarded by Dede Thomas. Gives off to Miller at the elbow. He's going to drive in, throws in. That's going to be almost went out of bounds, recovered by Tennyson. Fourth on the shot clock. Peavy, he's not aware of it. He's going to drive in, and the Horned Frogs will not get a shot off. It's like they were very unaware of the expiring play clock. And that will be a turnover. Bearcats get possession once again.
And Lockin and Bandega doing such a good job at suffocating that paint and not allowing anything inside.
Thomas crosses half court, standing near the logo. Gets a screen by Lockin, goes right side. Thomas is going to drive in, gets off the corner. Skillings, three-pointer to take the lead. No good, rebounded by Peavy. Gives it to Miller. Miller's going to drive in like a bullet. Layup is no good. Ends up in the hands of Josh Reed. There's a fight for it. Reed still has it, who gives off the Lockin. 53 seconds left to go. Thomas has it the left wing. Doesn't give it to Reed. Step back three to take the lead, and it's no good. Fight for it, ends up his hands of Skillings, and one, and it can't fall. Thought he had it, it looked good from here, but Skillings will go to the line to shoot two free throws. This will be the first visit to the line for the Bearcats. Horned Frogs not agreeing with that call, as Jacoby Cole is talking to the ref.
The Bearcats have kept a very fast pace of play, even one that, you know, might have some fans saying slow it down, but thus far it's working, and it's got them back in this ball game. And right now, Dan Skillings has a chance to tie it up. If he makes both, he's got two.
First free throws up, and it falls in. A team that struggled at the charity stripe. Skillings gets his first free throw of the night, and the Bearcats' first free throw of the night. Skillings gets the ball. He's going to go for a second free throw. And it's no good. Rebounded by Peavy.
And that one leaves the Bearcats just 1 point shy of the tie. It's 33-32 in favor of TCU.
Avery Anderson heavily guarded by Dede Thomas at the logo. 27 seconds left to go. 14 the play clock. Here's some movement. He's going to get a screen by Cole. He's going to drive in. Loses footing. It's going to be a travel call. Bearcats will get what is likely the final shot of the half. So with the Bearcats getting the last shot of the half, Lukasz is coming in.
I think we all know what that means. At least they're going to make the defense flinch, but CMOS has been their guy so far to take those shots, the contested shots. He had one against Baylor that was really close, hit the back iron and just barely missed. He's got the confidence to shoot it and the ability to make it. So, of course, he's coming in here.
Bearcats going with a more small lineup. Lukash is in for Bandigo. And Locken will inbound it to Thomas. Takes it, and the clock will start. 19 seconds left to go. No shot clock. Four Bearcats beyond the arc. Locken at the post. 10 seconds. Movement at the baseline. Thomas has it. He's going to drive in, pull up, jumpers up. And it's no good. Rebounded by Peavy. 1 second. Puts up a heave. And it's no good. Hits Ethan, our director. Not a fan of that. But the Horned Frogs will enter the half 33-32 with a one-point lead. Horned Frogs, they started the game 9-for-10 shooting at the field. They end the half shooting 45%, 13-29 from the field, including 6-for-11 from beyond the arc.
And a scoring drought of 2 minutes and 14 seconds to close as well. Something just to know, the Bearcats only down one, 33-32.
When you look at it, they were 36 combined points in this game in the first 4.5 minutes of this ball game. The Bearcats shooting 50% from the field, shooting 14 of 28, including 3 of 9 beyond the arc. The Bearcats had no field goals in the last 2 minutes and 33 seconds of that half. And out of the 32 points, 20 points came in the paint. Bearcats were 8 of 11 for layups. And they had 4 points off of turnovers.
I'll tell you what, that tells you two things. That says that the Bearcats forwards are playing good ball down low. But it also means that there's a lack of guard play coming in as well. We see Dede Thomas miss the jumper there to close out the offense on the half for the Bearcats. There were just a lot of opportunities in the first half that we saw where the Bearcats guards came up short, ISO plays, open jumpers even, three-pointers. There wasn't a whole lot of involvement. And a lot of that had to do with the stagnation in the middle of the first half that had the Bearcats in their scoring drought. And then things started to click towards the end, and you know, we saw more involvement from them, but it still wasn't enough. And we'll definitely be looking for that going into the second half.
Another thing I want to point out is midway through the first half, the Bearcats were losing the turnover battle, I believe 5-1. They committed 5 turnovers, and the Horned Frogs were taking care of the ball with only one turnover. Now, at the end of the half, the Bearcats had 8 turnovers, and the Horned Frogs have 7 turnovers, a team that is so notoriously good for forcing turnovers amongst their opponents. However, that's not the case. At least it wasn't for the last 10 minutes of that first half. It is halftime. Horned Frogs up 33-32. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back here on Bearcats Sports Radio.
Halftime here in Cincinnati. Bearcats trail 33-32 to TCU. I'm Preston Baker, Henry Meinerding. You know, I just happened to hop on at halftime here. Give us something during halftime today. But another game, four conference games now. You haven't led at halftime in any of them, but you've led in the final four, in the final minute of the first three of them. So not leading at halftime doesn't really matter all too much, but it did feel like you were going to have a possession at the end right there, and a good look by Dede Thomas just didn't quite fall to be able to take a lead in the break.
Right, and this is nothing new for the Bearcats if you've seen them so far in Big 12 play. Here's another tough opponent, another ranked opponent. They're four straight. They'll have six. Upcoming, they have Kansas and Oklahoma. Correct me if I'm wrong. But
yeah, flipped around the other way. Then Kansas. But yes, yep.
In that order. So the Bearcats, a tough schedule to open up here. But they've competed. And here we are again, another tough opponent. TCU's had a great 2024. And we're here competing with them. We're only down one and a half. And we definitely have the momentum on our side. The end of that half closed well for the Bearcats, I'd say, aside from the last play. A missed jumper right around the free throw line from Dede Thomas. But everything that you wanted from the Bearcats to close out the half, a little bit dry to start, to say the least. The Bearcats couldn't seem to get anything to click.
And it was the ball game, too, where so far you've definitely felt like, I wouldn't say you're obviously the more talented team, but it's not like you're devoid of any talent between these two teams. I mean, they're going to go blow for blow there. Just because TCU's 19th in the country doesn't mean Cincinnati is not going to be able to compete with them. And we've seen that. Sometimes when Cincinnati speeds this game up, it kind of benefits the Bearcats. So it'll be interesting to see if they kind of deal with that a little bit more. They really try to go, because that's been the case for a lot of this. And TCU's a team that makes mistakes, and they make mistakes when you're trying to run things fast. That was really how they blew out Oklahoma the other day, and that was really kind of why it happened, was TCU was able to get settled. They ran their kind of basketball. They kind of slowed the ball game down, and because of that, they were able to win in blowout fashion against Oklahoma. Cincinnati hasn't been able to let them do that so far today, and it's really helped out too. And there's been a lot of hustle plays early in this one that Cincinnati has been the beneficiary of, and you know, getting this crowd going, we always talk about it doesn't take much. A lot of those hustle plays have done just that.
Right, the Bearcats missing a big factor tonight. He's out there on the floor, just not playing his best. That's Dan Skillings. He's only shooting 1 of 6 right now. He's coming off a game where he scored 24 and grabbed 6 boards, and then here he is tonight. He's shooting 1 of 6, 1 of 3 from three-pointer, and he's missed a free throw. He's 1 of 2 there. A lackadaisical half thus far for Mr. Skillings. We hope to see him go off a little bit more in the second half. You know, he's known for that ISO ball that he likes to play and his fast breaks, and it just hasn't translated thus far.
You know, that is one thing that's funny, too, is this one shot he did make was a three to ultimately complete a comeback of what was 9 points at one point, and his three tied that ball game back up. So, you know, when the moment gets big, he's there.
Just when you think he's not there, he's still there, right?
Trying to keep him there for the whole time. And we've seen some of Aziz Bandego again today. You know, he's finally back from that injury. He's still wearing that kind of, I don't know what, if it's a compression band or what, around his midsection while he's on the bench. So his back is still kind of working back to 100%. His play kind of shows that he's still trying to work back to 100% and is not fully there right now, too.
Right, just having him on the court, though, is enough. At sometimes, you got Victor Locken down there in the post already, and you see another man the size of him, Aziz Bandego, down there. It's suffocating for the TCU offense when they try to look for points inside and are forced to take tougher jumpers from further away.
Yeah, and these two teams have been shooting the ball really well early in this one, too. Cincinnati's 50% from the field, 14 for 28. There's not many times where you're going to be shooting 50% from the field with 28 attempted shots at halftime and not be in the lead. Today's just one of those days for Cincinnati. 3 for 9 from three, 1 for 2 from the free throw line. Free throws have been an issue in conference play, that's for sure, but we've only had the one trip to the line so far. For TCU, a lot of the same, truly. I mean, very similar numbers. 13 for 29 from the field for 45%. 6 for 11 from three. That's 55%. You're going to need to get that down a little bit in the second half.
That's been the game changer, no doubt. They opened up hot from three and started to slow down, but still 6 of those things coming in the first half. That's not going to help the Bearcats at all. And you mentioned the free throws. We're only 1 of 2, but then again, we've only shot 2. The problem with that is, if you're a Bearcat fan, player, coach, people are going to write stories, and you see they're going to say the Bearcats opened up their first four games only shooting X percent from the free throw line, and 50% is not good, even though it's only been two free throws.
Yeah, and that's something, too, that probably once this game gets going in the second half, if it stays as a tight game, you're going to need to try to get to the hoop, get to the free throw line, find your way to get those points with the clock shut off, make it easy for yourself. It's not an easy sport. We've seen that, you know, comes down to one or two points. You still have a positive point differential in conference play right now, even with this one-point differential right now. You're still plus six total in conference play, even with this. So, you know, it's going to be a point here or there that's actually really going to be the difference in this ball game. And that's one of those things you have to kind of think about if you're Cincinnati, is maybe going to the rim one time and going and hitting two of your free throws is going to be what's going to help you win this ball game.
Yeah, looking into the second half, definitely getting to the hoop more. And also, I'd like to see him open up here and try and take the lead. The Bearcats haven't led so far in the game. TCU's biggest lead has been at 11, and that was 7 minutes and 33 seconds to go. However, their biggest scoring run's only 5. So they didn't really take off. It was more slow momentum that built them up to that 11-point lead. The Bearcats actually have a bigger scoring run with 7, and that was the scoring run that got them back into this ball game and tied it.
Yeah, neither team's been able to really knock away a ton at once, which is a good thing because defensively you're playing well, but then offensively you're not really able to draw much back. And that's something that, it's a good thing it's only a one-point game because you don't need a big run to go back in this one. And you are not going to start the half with the ball, but, you know, one defensive stop, go down and hit a layup, and you've got your first lead of the day. And I think that's going to be something coming out of the half. You're going to need to try to keep this game right where it is or get it back towards your side. You just can't let TCU start off hot like you did in the first half.
And if you're Wes Miller, a little deja vu here heading into the second half as the Bearcats trail 33-32. A close one coming up and a good one here for you guys in the second half here at Fifth Third.
Take a little look around the conference here too. We're the only game in action right this second. 33-32 TCU at halftime. Baylor goes to Kansas State. They're going to tip off in about a minute or two, 8 o'clock. Kansas plays at Oklahoma State at 9. Iowa State's at BYU at 9 as well. And then tomorrow, once we load it up, it'll be, let's see, who else hasn't played? Oklahoma, Houston, I don't think I said Iowa State's name and somebody else. But,
yeah,
you know, there's another four that got to go tomorrow. But as far as the conference goes here, see around the country if there's anything interesting as well. But, you know, it is funny. I came over here, had class until about 7:20, 7:25, and was like, you know, I'll see how deep in the game. Didn't look at the score once. I walk in, I'm like, man, that's not how I expected the game to be going so far. And then since I got in here, Cincinnati's been controlling this ball game for the last about 8 minutes of the half. So it's been a good part of the half so far. Cincinnati, momentum on your side. Building is full. Building's raucous. I mean, the crowd is at your back again, which is going to help a ton down the stretch here. And now it's one of those, it sucks trying to think of a game against a ranked opponent as almost a must win per se, but you really feel like you need this game after the two you've dropped really by one possession each of the last two.
Right, and knowing the two that you have ahead as well. This one, you got it close. So it's one that you want to finish because you might not have the next two close at halftime. You play a very good Kansas team, very good Oklahoma team who could put you out by halftime. You look at this one, you look back at it, and let's say they lose, the Bearcats end up losing by one. You look at this one, and you're like, ah, should have won that one.
Yeah, you know, that's the good thing about this conference. You only need to win about 7 or 8 of these to feel like you're a good team, but you've only won one so far.
It's a tough conference.
You've got to keep it moving.
This is not the American.
Wrapping things up. Oh, got those Wednesday games. So tomorrow, West Virginia goes to Oklahoma, UCF goes to Texas, and Texas Tech goes to Houston. That wraps up the weekday slate for the Big 12. But any final thoughts before we send it off to the second half here?
I got to win this one. I liked how we closed out. Talking about this, the Bearcats got a tough couple of games ahead, and you really want to get this one.
Yeah, gotta feel like you gotta have this one. And a couple guys, I think Josh Reed played really well towards the end of the half there. He hits a couple shots. His defense has been great. So we'll take a quick, real quick break, and we'll send it back for the second half. Halftime here in Cincinnati. Bearcats 32, Horned Frogs 33. You're listening to Bearcat Basketball.
Welcome back to Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. My name is Aiden Riggs. I'm joined by my partner, Henry Minor Ding. We are back for the second half of action here between the University of Cincinnati Bearcats and the 19th-ranked TCU Horned Frogs. At the half, the Horned Frogs lead 33-32 over the Bearcats. Horned Frogs, believe we'll start off with the ball. Henry, what did you think of that first half?
Yeah, me and Preston were just talking about how we were proud of the Bearcats for keeping it close, but it seems like a little deja vu here. This is the one that you want to close and actually get the win, and we got a half a basketball ahead of us. It's definitely a lot to prove here for the Bearcats.
Horned Frogs will start with the ball. Tennyson has it up top. He gives it off to Anderson. Anderson moves to his right, back out to Tennyson on the left side. Tennyson guarded by Newman. Up top, it's Peavy. Peavy now back to Tennyson. Into the corner, it goes to Miller. Miller works it to his right. Back up top to Anderson. Anderson looks for what he's got, moves to his left off the screen. Back up top, Tennyson fakes the three. Guarded closely by Newman. Pass outside, back to Anderson. Back out to the left, it's Peavy. Peavy pulls up from inside, no good. Gets his win up for his own rebound. That ball is going to be called in the Bearcats' favor. Thought it might have went off Bandego's leg, though. Officials discussing it will be TCU ball. Went off the foot of Aziz Bandego going up for the rebound.
Yeah, and I was thinking the same thing there. Wrong call. Bandego even had a little side eye on his face. We all knew that one went off his leg.
With that, the Horned Frogs throw it in underneath their own basket. Thrown into Tennyson. His shot is up. It's no good. Rebounded by Bandego. Bearcats now in transition. Up. Long pass to John Newman. His shot is no good, but put back by Victor Lockin.
And that's Lockin's second put back of the day. He's always there, and he's always lingering, and that's what makes him so great.
Bearcats take a 34-33 lead over the Horned Frogs. Stolen away by Lockin. Pass up. Day-Day Thomas. Day-Day with speed. Jams it in. Day-Day Thomas. Jams it in for the Bearcats. They lead 36-33.
And watch out. We saw Avery Anderson clear the basket there as he did not want to be put on a highlight reel.
Bearcats come out swinging. Take a three-point lead early. Here come the Horned Frogs. It's Peavy on the right side. Faked his shot, guarded closely by Lukosis. Back up top, it's Miller. Faked it, works inside on Lockin. Puts the shot up, it's no good. Bounced off a couple hands. Goes out of bounds. It's called in the Horned Frogs' favor. They will have the throw in front of their own bench.
And Bandego was questioning about leaping over that Horned Frog bench for it there. Decided to stay in and let it roll out, or bounce out.
TCU scored 26 points in the first 7 minutes of the first half. Scored seven the rest of the way. Started off very hot, slowed down since. Anderson's going to throw it in. Off the ball foul is going to be called on Aziz Bandego. He caught Uda down low. TCU will throw it in once again, this time from the baseline. Anderson's going to throw it in, gets it into Tennyson. Tennyson now works it up top, back to Anderson. Anderson just off the CPAL logo, guarded by Day-Day Thomas. Works the way to his right, back up top Tennyson. Peavy now on the left side. Peavy on the wing, back up top, made its way to Anderson, back to Tennyson on the fifth third logo. Inside to Uday. Uday gonna hand it off to Anderson. His shot's up, it's a buzzer, and he makes it in, ties the game at 36.
And honestly, that's good defense from the Bearcats. That was a tough shot, he just happened to make it, now tying the game at 36.
Anderson gets on the board, Bearcats look for an answer. Bandego at the top of the key. Looked at Lukosis, doesn't have it. Day-Day Thomas for three, no good off the back of the rim, rebounded by Anderson of the Horned Frogs. Here come the Frogs with speed up the right side of the court. slow down once they get to the top of the arc. So the pass was knocked away by Victor Locken. That pass is knocked away by Day-Day Thomas. Bearcats being aggressive towards the ball.
And they're alive and active so far. A couple tip passes there. You could tell that the Bearcats have the Horned Frogs on their heels, on their toes.
Xavier Cork is going to enter the game for the Horned Frogs, replacing Ernest Uday. Peavy will throw it in front of his own coach. That ball is thrown in. It went off the hands of Emmanuel Miller. Bearcat basketball.
And you can argue that we were due for that one after the last couple possessions and then what we saw here. Good defense from the Bearcats to open up the half.
Day-Day Thomas slowly carries the ball up for the Cats. Works it to his right, gets it to Locken, the outside wing. Back up to Bandego up top. Newman in the far side. Lukosius now up top. Looks down low to Locken. Couldn't get it to him. He's looking for the foul. It went out of bounds. It'll be Horned Frog basketball. Fifth Third Arena, not a fan of that no call. We'll play on Horned Frog basketball. Tennyson now. Hands it off to Anderson. Works it just off the CPAL logo on the left side. Thought about going there. Works his way. Pulls up from the top of the key. No good at the back of the rim. Victor Locken comes down with it. Here's Day-Day Thomas at the right side. Pass to Newman. Newman now goes up with it. And one! John Newman went up and made it. Foul on the way. He'll get one chance at the line.
Yeah, and you could tell from the way that he was cutting that he was going to have that confidence to go up for that contested layup, and he finished it perfectly. Now at the line.
John Newman got his 11th point of the game. He'll look for his 12th from the line.
Newman has been fantastic today. A flawless game thus far.
Jameel Reynolds will enter the game for Aziz Bandego for the Bearcats. Newman now with the ball at the line. Shot is up. No good off the back of the rim. Horned Frogs come down with it.
And there's that announcer's curse I talk about how flawless his game is. He misses the free throw. Great. All right, TCU ball.
Anderson with it up top. Guarded by Day-Day Thomas. Hands it off to Miller. Miller works it to the right. Gets it to Mustafa. Mustafa now back to Miller. Miller's three is up. It's no good off the back of the rim. Bounces off a couple hands. Horned Frogs come down with it. It was Peavy. Back up top, Tennyson. Deep three from the top. It's good. Tavion Tennyson from deep gives the Horned Frogs the lead once again, 39-38.
And Jameel Reynolds, not using two hands on that board, punishes the Bearcats as TCU is able to kick it out and score the three.
John Newman backing down his man. Went up with a shot. He's fouled. He'll go to the line for two on that one.
See, I'm not even going to say anything this time.
Newman at the line for his first shot. First shot is up. It's no good off the front of the rim. That one was not pretty.
You might hear the air ball chants. That's in reference to the Horned Frogs subbing in Jameer Nelson Jr., who airballed one early, and those chants aren't going away anytime soon.
John Newman 0 for 2 from the line. He'll have his third shot here. He shoots 76% on the year. That shot is up. No good, too. That one was not pretty either, but he gets his own rebound. Goes back up with it. Finger roll. No good. Comes down with it again. Working the boards on his own shots. John Newman gets it up top to Day-Day Thomas. They'll reset. 13 on the shot clock. Thomas working to his left. Drives in the paint. Puts up a little finger roll. No good. Bounces off thought it went off a Horned Frog defender, but it's going to go in their favor. Horned Frogs are going to throw it in underneath the basket.
A tough stint for the Bearcats there, and specifically Newman. A pair of missed free throws followed by a missed layup. And as he was moving out towards the corner of the three-point line, he's called for a sub.
Fifth Third Arena is not happy right now with this call off that ball that went out of bounds. Refs discussed it. Will remain Horned Frog basketball.
And Wes Miller would have been right there to see it.
He's following the ref down the court, making him get an earful.
Not to say that wouldn't skew his bias, but he was there.
Jameer Nelson, newly into the game, works his way to his left. He's tripped down. Foul will be called. With that, we'll go to timeout here. Horned Frogs lead 39-38, 15:55 remaining in the second half. We'll return shortly after break. Welcome back to Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. So far in this Big 12 matchup, the TCU Horned Frogs lead 39-38 with 15 minutes to go in the second half. Henry, what have you thought about this hot start in the second half?
Yeah, the Bearcats came out hot, and it's exactly what they needed. It's what we talked about during the halftime show, and it's what the Bearcats needed to get themselves going in the second half. It's been a little back and forth and chippy. Ever since, but the Bearcats definitely look like the better team coming out. They'll look to get that back here as we continue. 15:55 left here in the ball game.
Bearcats took their first lead of the game just a couple minutes ago when they led 36-33. TCU has stormed back after a couple turnovers from the Bearcats. Interesting note that turnover margin is tied at 9. We knew that would be a big thing coming into the game as TCU averages almost 17 turnovers, forced turnovers a game. TCU will have the ball on an inbounds throw from beneath the Bearcat basketball. Throwing it in will be Jameer Nelson. He looks for what he's got, gets it in to Miller. Miller, guarded by Newman. Fakes to his right, now moves there. Backs down Newman. Kins a cross-court pass to Nelson. Nelson works the baseline, sends one up, and good, off the top of the backboard. 41-38, the Horned Frogs lead. Bearcats looking for an answer. Day-Day Thomas with it up the left side. Odio Guama up top. Newman, three from the right wing. No good off the front of the rim. Rebounded by the Horned Frogs. Here comes Tennyson. Tennyson moving with speed, as we've seen TCU do. Tries to find the pass down low. It's stolen away by Dan Skillings. Skillings gets his pass up to Thomas. Thomas works it up the right side. Gets it to Newman on the right wing. Inside to Odio Guama. Oguama backs down his man, looks for a pass, back out to Newman. Newman with it on the Fifth Third logo, directs his offense, now sends it across to Day-Day Thomas. Thomas works on his man, now cuts back to the left, tried to get a pass in the corner, stolen away by the Horned Frogs. Here comes Miller. Miller, pass outside, the three is up, and it's good. Jacoby Coles finds the three.
Yeah, and if you're John Newman right now, I know in 2K we all played it. He's got a little blue circle around him. He's cold. That was a bad defensive possession. He wasn't able to get back and set in time to defend that three ball, and it falls.
Bearcats once again looking for an answer. It's Newman up top to the corner to Day-Day Thomas, and he works it towards the baseline. Back up top to Newman. Newman works in on his man. Step back. Shot is up. No good. Odio Guamo with the offensive rebound, though. Shot clock resets. Sent a cross-court pass that they say went straight out of bounds. Thought it was deflected off the Horned Frogs, but it looks like it'll be Horned Frog basketball.
And a little bit of deja vu here from the start of the game. Bearcats are cold, and TCU is starting to pick up momentum. You'd like to see them get a stop here on defense. Otherwise, things could start to trickle out of hand.
TCU on a 7-0 run over the last 2:20. Three for their last three. Bearcats, no baskets in the last 2:43. Here come the Horned Frogs, working inside. Jameer Nelson makes his way to the paint. They're going to call him on a travel, though. It'll be Bearcat basketball.
And that's one way to get a stop.
Take him out, you get him.
An offensive error there from Nelson. A travel down low, real close to the restricted arc. And it's Bearcat basketball.
Bearcats will have the ball. Jizzle James now in the game for the Cats. He'll take the ball up the floor. James works his way to his left. Worked it just inside the arc, now kicks it back out. Dan Skillings up top. He's going to take the screen from Aziz Bandego. Now up to Lukosis. Lukosis' pass is deflected by the Horned Frog. He had a little body contact there too, but Lukosis grabs the ball. He's fouled though as he tries to cut inside. Foul is going to be called on Anderson. It's his second of the game.
And Anderson commits the foul there, but I'm actually going to give him the benefit of the doubt that that was a smart foul, because if not, Lukosius had a free path to the basket. Would have got two. Instead, he's inbounding. Or no, they're swapping out. Skillings will inbound now.
Ball will be thrown in on the far side from us. Skillings gets it in to Jizzle James. James up top. Finds Josh Reed. Reed to the top of the key to Lukosis. Lukosis works it to the right, took a screen from Bandego, back up top to Reed. Now it's James on the left side of the court. James lost the ball for a second, pulls up, no good. Battle for a rebound comes down with it as the Horned Frogs.
And that's just not a smart jumper. It seemed forced. It was a fadeaway from James, but he never got his feet set.
Here come the Horned Frogs. Alley-oop is up and good. Ernest Uday slams it home for the Frogs.
And he's looking at his hand. Maybe he hurt his wrist or his hand there on that slam. It was a tough slam.
Jizzle James with it now for the Cats. Pull-up jumper. No good, but he's fouled on the way up. Jizzle James will go to the line for two.
Ernest Uday still looking at his hand off that alley-oop. He really threw it down. Good play from James there. Draws the contact. Off the baseline, a mid-range fadeaway, and now he's at the line.
James with the ball in his hand, ready for his first shot. It is up, and it is good. James gets on the board for the first time tonight. Victor Locken will come into the game. Jizzle shooting 81% from the line this year. Jizzle's shot is up. It's no good off the back of the rim. Foul is going to be called on Bandego. Fifth third, not a fan of that one. Horned Frogs will throw it in off that one. They lead 45-39 over the Cats. 13 minutes to go here in the second. Up top is Jameer Nelson. Works it inside the key. Drives towards the basket. Bandego swats it away, but a foul is called on the way up. I believe it was called on Jizzle James. This second of the game. Nelson's going to go to the line for two. The fans not too happy about it.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what happened there. It seemed like a cluster of Bearcats were underneath the basket. But Bandego definitely got a clear block on that one. And you can hear from the fans. We see it on the big screen. Didn't look like a foul here.
Nelson misses his first shot.
Fouled online, maybe.
Fifth third might have helped with that one a little bit. Fans start chanting air ball at him, reminding him of the first half. Second shot is up. That one's also no good, but TCU trying to tip it in. Locken comes down with it. Here come the Bearcats. Jizzle James stops at half court. Works it to the right. Slow movement from James up top to Locken. Locken moves it to the left. Tries to find a cutting Skillings. Skillings puts it up and in easily. Dan Skillings gets the Cats within four.
That's only Skilling's second made basket of the game, but good to see him get involved, and now the crowd is in it.
Fifth third comes alive. Here's Nelson for the Horned Frogs. Puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Skilling's. Here come the Cats. Skilling's up the right side with speed. Working his way inside. Spin move. It's up. Finger roll is in.
And that's the Cats exact situation that you need to put Dan Skilling's in. He loves the fast break. He runs it there, gets elevation, and makes the layup.
Cats get within two. Fifth third comes alive. 30-second timeout by the Horned Frogs.
And man, what a run from the Bearcats there.
This place is rocking.
Took a pair of missed free throws from Jameer Nelson Jr. And from there was all Bearcat. And Dan Skilling's back-to-back buckets, the second a fast break layup off the spin. I've been saying it as long as he's been a Bearcat that he's got some NBA talent within him. He's young and he's got a deep back and he can put that kind of move on defenders, and the cut before that was beautiful as well. The Bearcats only down two now, 45-43. 12:06 to go. Surprising, the Bearcats only shooting 27% from three.
Cold night, 3 for 11.
But still only down two.
I think the thing that's most surprising to me is both teams' free throw percentage. TCU 25% from the line, with the Bearcats only 29.
It's a bloodbath out here.
Those are easy points being left on the board by both teams.
Maybe the team that wins it is the first team to start hitting them. Who knows? But yeah, the Bearcats definitely struggling and have struggled. They're 28.6, just to reiterate, 28.6% from the free throw line. The stat that sticks out right now is the TCU is 53.3 from three-point range, but still only up two, which means the Bearcats have done a good job defensively elsewhere. And the Bearcats have put up more shots. Right now, the Cincinnati leaders, Newman, has 11 points. He's also the leader in rebounds with six, even though he went kind of cold there before the Bearcats run. And Day-Day Thomas is still the Bearcat leader for assists. He has four.
John Newman with 11 points to go along with it. He's got six rebounds, getting into the double-double range if he keeps it up. We saw him on that one drive earlier get two offensive boards on his own shots.
Really good for the Bearcats to see Skilling start coming back in this ball game. He's definitely been their man to watch, so to see him have such a tough first half is tough being a Bearcats fan and seeing that, but I'm glad that he's finally starting to feel himself and come to life here in the second half.
Skilling's now with 8 points in the day. UC is 12-1 when he scores 10-plus points in the game. One more basket. Looks pretty good in the Bearcats' favor. Players start to re-enter the court. Fifth third is still alive through the timeout. TCU will inbound the ball. It'll be Tennyson in front of his own bench. It's guarded closely by Dan Skilling on the inbound. We're going to throw it in to the other side of the court to Jameer Nelson. Nelson works it up the court with speed, working on Jizzle James. Up top, made his way to Miller. Now Tennyson on the left side. Tennyson. Working on Skilling's once again. Back up top to Nelson. Nelson to his left. Works it inside. Back outside to Tennyson. Tennyson with a deep three off the pass. It's good. Another deep three for him. TV on Tennyson. Spans the lead to five.
And Tennyson has been their man. He's 4 for 6 from three-point range tonight.
Bearcats with it now. Locking with a nice pass behind his back to Lukosis. Lukosis with a little pull-up jumper. No good. The back to the rim. Horned Frogs come down with it. Peavy now. Middle of the court. Gives it to Tennyson. Tennyson thought about pulling up again. Instead, hands it off to Uday. Uday works on Bandego. Goes up with the foul. And it's good. He'll go to the line for one more. They now lead by seven.
Yeah, and a tough break for the Bearcats. A long three followed by an and one.
with that, we've reached the under 12 timeout. The TCU Horned Frogs lead 50-43. We'll return shortly.
Test.
Welcome back inside Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. The TCU Horned Frogs currently lead 50-43. I'm joined alongside once again by Chris Pagan.
What's up, guys?
At the line for the Horned Frogs is Ernest Uday. Chance to extend the lead. First shot is up, and it is good. His converts it on his and one, makes the lead an 8-point lead.
And, you know, you look at the Horned Frogs, they're shooting. They made their last 6 out of 8 field goal attempts. You know, they're getting, you know, in their groove once again.
Jizzle with the little alley-oop up there to Aziz Bandego. He slams it home, gets him back within 6.
And that's good because in the previous matchups, there have been miscommunication with Bandego on those alley-oops. It's good to see one of those finally go through.
Quick basket by Jameer Nelson. See if the Bearcats can respond to that one. Bandego up top. Over to John Newman. Newman cutting inside. Gets into the paint, will be fouled. Foul's going to be called on Miller. That'll be a second. Apologize, it's actually his first. Dede Thomas back into the game for the Cats, replacing Jizzle James. Lukosis will throw it in underneath the basket for the Bearcats. Guarded closely by Peavy. Going to just throw it up for Locke, and he gets it. Locke in backing down his man. It's Miller. Locke in the paint. Goes around with it. He's fouled. Now Miller gets his second foul tonight.
It looks like that's their 6th foul of the half, so I believe one more will put him in the bonus. And with 10 minutes to go, that could be very critical down the road of this game. You know, we've seen the Bearcats and free throws have not been a good duo together, but hopefully that can change if we do get into that scenario, which the Bearcats are in the bonus.
Lukosis throws it in again. Quick pass inside to John Newman. He slams it home.
Caught the Horned Frogs napping. Looks like that was Travian Tennyson's man and just lost him as Newman drove in and threw down the hammer on the inbound pass.
Cats starting to heat up, matching the Horned Frogs. Four of their last five. Horned Frogs with it now, outside. It's Nelson. Nelson kicks it up top. Tennyson on the outside. Now it's Miller. He'll pull it for three. That one's good. Quick answer once again from the Horned Frogs. Lead now at nine. Bearcats trying to match the speed. They slow up, though, the last second. Bandego up top. Was looking for a cutting Lukosis. Now cuts it inside. Sends it back up top to Thomas. Thomas moves into the paint. He puts up the little finger roll up and in, and it's good.
Dede Thomas driving in with confidence. You know, he had the big man, Isam Mustafa, in his face, and that did not stop him from driving in and putting it off the glass.
Nelson with it for the Horned Frogs. They lead by seven, 9:30 to go in the second. Nelson working to his left. Thought about the shot, no good. They lost the ball there and a little confused, and here comes Lukosis. Lukosis now, he's fouled as he goes into the paint. He'll go to the line for possibly two unless they call it on the floor. He will be shooting two.
Bearcats now on the bonus with 9:23 left to go in this game. That could be significant.
Don't want to call that a good foul from the Horned Frogs, so that might have been.
I mean, Lukosis was a two-on-one for the Bearcats. I mean, it's kind of give one, take one. You know, you can either give Lukosis the basket or force him to the line. But when you force him to the line, now you put them in the bonus. So it's one of those difficult situations for the Horned Frogs.
Bearcats, as we mentioned, shooting 29% from the line today. That'll go up there as he converts his first one. The Horned Frogs lead. Seamoss shooting 79% from the line this year. Has the ball for a second. Takes a dribble, puts it up, and it's good. Horned Frogs lead now at 5, 56-51, 9:23 remaining. Fifth third comes to its feet and comes alive as the fans get into it. Avery Anderson took it up, gets it to Tennyson. Inside to Miller. Miller cross-court pass back to Anderson. Anderson cuts inside. He was met by Bandego, and he loses the ball to Lockett. Here comes Dede Thomas with speed. Thomas into the paint, goes up with it. No good off the backboard. And here come the Horned Frogs now with the ball. It's Anderson. Puts it up and in easily. That was Miller. I apologize. They regain the lead, or they make their lead back to seven.
You mentioned in the pregame show that only we heard, fast break points, TCU. One of the highest scoring teams with fast break points, I believe, averaging 22.8 fast break points per game.
Bearcats with it now. Seamoss Lukosis faked the three. Now gets it back up top to Newman. Newman working to his right. Now Seamoss is going to pull up with it. No good off side of the rim. Bandego went up for it. Foul is going to be called on the Horned Frogs.
So that'll send Bandego to the line. He's a 61% free throw shooter on the year, going 1-1. Or he'll be a 1-1, excuse me.
Z's almost looked like he didn't want to go to the line there for a second.
Looks like there's some confusion between him and Lukosis.
Z's shooting 60% from the line this year. Gathers the ball. Shot is up and is good. Gets the Bearcats back within six.
And when you're 7 foot, you know, shooting free throws is not an easy thing.
No.
You know, and takes, you know, a lot of skill, especially for that size. We'll see if Bandego, you know, can go 2 for 2 at the line right here.
The ref was talking very closely to Victor Lockin. Fans clearly are not happy about it.
They've been unhappy quite a bit this game with a few questionable calls, but we'll leave that in the past.
Bandego's shot is up, and it's good. Bearcats back within five, 58-53. The Horned Frogs lead, 8:28 remaining in the second.
Horned Frogs five out of the last five shooting from the field. Bearcats need to stop on defense.
Nelson works it to his left. Lockin challenged his pass to Coles, but Coles was able to gather it. Coles with it now, drilling the top of the key. Back to Nelson. He's going to motion his offense quarterback at all. He's going to pull up with a three. No good from deep. Bandego went up for it. He knocked it out of bounds. He and Lockin almost collided in midair. Lockin was looking for the foul. TCU will third and underneath the basket. Josh Reed's going to come into the game for John Newman.
And right there, that was a chance for the Bearcats. to get out of that defensive possession, and looks like him and Erlockin and Bandego had a little miscommunication on whether who's going to get that rebound. Both went for it, ended up going out of bounds.
Nelson throws it into Anderson. He's going to take it to the top of the key. 15 remains on the shot clock. 8 to go in the game. Works to his right, tried to get a screen, doesn't get it. Still has the ball, works it all the way to the baseline. Says a pass to Coles in the corner. Coles fake the three, moves inside a little bit, then pulls up with a jumper. It's good.
You're right there. Nice pump fake, got locking the jump, and he just drove in along the baseline and pulled up right near the block. A little mid-range jumper.
Here's Thomas now, working to the right. Has a little bit of an open lane, moved in into it for a second. Now brings it back up top. Thomas moves inside, finger roll up and in, no good. Bandego with the offensive board. Went up, had some contact, it's not called. Goes out of bounds, it's gonna be Bearcats basketball. It'll be Bearcats basketball after we come back from break. Bearcats, no field goals in the last 2 minutes and 22 seconds. Horned Frogs complete opposite, 6 for the last 7 from the field. With that, we'll go to break and be right back. It's Horned Frogs 60, Bearcats 53, 7:36 remaining. We'll be back in a minute. Welcome back to Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. We return with 7:26 remaining in the second half. Bearcats down 53-60 to the 19th ranked TCU Horned Frogs.
And for the Bearcats, when you think you got an edge on TCU, when you think they finally lost the rhythm, they hit you right again. That's been the problem in the second half. Bearcats, a few self-inflicted errors, but you know, they're only down 7 minutes to go. That's obviously doable. Let's see what they can do to end off this game.
Bearcats will have the ball out of this timeout. Simas Lukosis has it beneath the basket. Waits for his offense to develop, looking for a pass. Can't find much. Tried to get into locking. They're going to lose it off the pass. Another turnover for the Bearcats. Here come the Horned Frogs. Up top of this, Anderson. Anderson moves it to his left. Look for a pass. Gets it cross-court to Nelson. Over to Coles on the left side. Back to the right side, it goes to Nelson. Nelson staring down Thomas. Works it to his left, makes the move. Now back outside to Anderson. Anderson cuts in, finds Cole down low. He might have got away with a walk, but Skillings comes away with the ball. Skillings, cross-court pass to Thomas. Skillings with it now. Tried to jam it in, he missed it. Foul is called, though, and he went down hard.
He's holding his hand. not a good look for the Bearcats at all.
Skillings just missed the dunk. Went down hard on his hand. Gets back up. See if he can go to the line. Holding his right wrist.
I'm not sure if this wrist collided with the rim, because those rims, when you go for a dunk, they are hard. They are hard. And the reason why I say that, because he was holding his hand before he hit the ground, which why I look at that kind of eliminates the possibility of it being a contact injury on the floor.
They're reviewing this one, it appears, for a flagrant on the way up. I didn't get a good enough look at what happened.
At least from fast pace, it didn't seem intentional.
There's not... Oh! When he came down, it looked like he came down on the wrist. It was a legitimate reaction for me to seeing that one.
See, they only show one replay. No, we need more.
I doubt that we're going to see much called here, other than the common foul.
Yeah, like I said, it really didn't seem intentional, at least in fat and real-time motion, and even on the replay, it didn't seem intentional. It's just a basketball play, you know, an unfortunate play that happened where Skillings ended up falling on his wrist and possibly injuring it, but I don't see any malicious intent. I agree with you. I think it would be a common foul. I'll be surprised if it's more than that. And it's not like the NBA where they announce it to the crowd, they have the camera. Nah, they'll give a signal.
I've seen a couple games where they've tried to this year in college. There's been a couple of them where they've gone on the mic to say what they're looking at.
Usually they'll tell the PA guy and he'll relay it.
I believe I was watching the Kentucky-Florida game when they were doing that. They caught me off guard.
I believe common foul, two shots. Crowd reacts as a kid on the Jumbotron is signaling tech. He's spamming the T.
Just a common foul will be called.
That's going to be number three on Micah Peavy.
Skilling to the line now for two shots. First one is up, and it just rattles home. Two subs coming in for the Horned Frogs. It'll be 11 Tennyson. I believe number two, Miller. Locken came out of the game for the Bearcats. The pass to Skillings. Wasn't ready for it. Lost the ball. Now he gets it.
That's Big 12 basketball for you.
Shots up, no good off the front of the rim, but he comes down his own rebound. Skillings with it. Inside to Newman. Up to Bantego. Bantego slams it home. Azeez Bantego slams it home. Gets to the Bearcats within four.
Great pass by John Newman. He had Lukasz behind a wide open for three, but chose to go the easy route underneath the Bandego for the easy two.
Fifth third comes to its feet. Here come the Horned Frogs, though, trying to put them back in their seats. Avery Anderson up top, just off the C-Paul logo. Waits for his offense to develop. Guarded by Day-Day Thomas. Takes the screen. Works inside. Bandego tried to get it on the way up. Comes down. Uday comes down with it. Bounce around a couple hands, and it's put in by Peavy.
I mean, that ball is bouncing around the rim.
Bandego with it now for the Cats. Looking for a pass, picked up his dribble, tried to get inside to Lukosis, but he loses it. Horned Frogs with it now. Up top, it's Anderson, picked up his dribble, looked for Tennyson now. Tennyson just off the C-paw. Works it up towards the midcourt line. Now it's Avery Anderson. Anderson taking his time, letting play develop, milking the clock. Moves to his left, picks up his dribble, stolen away by Thomas. Here comes Thomas, open court, slams it home. Day-Day Thomas once again. The Horned Frogs lead 62-58 as the Bearcats get within four.
Thomas leads the team with 24 steals coming into this game.
Cross-court pass now. Inside, it's Miller. His shot's up, no good. Offensive board by Uday, though. Puts it up and back in. Back and forth game. Bearcats looking for another answer.
I mean, it's been the second chance points for their Horned Frogs. like I mentioned earlier, the Bearcats think they have, and the Horned Frogs just come right back and score.
Cats with it now. Dan Skillings works his way inside. Little finger roll up and in. Puts it in. Stays within four. Five to go here.
Looked like he was trying to go for the hammer. Reached back. Then last second, like you said, finger roll. Falls in.
PV with it for the Frogs. To his right, it's Miller. Works it. Keeps working it to his right. Tennyson. Tennyson's going to take the screen from Uday. Works it to the middle. Stolen away by Day-Day Thomas. Day-Day once again. Open court. Oh, the finger roll. He just misses.
You know, Avery Anderson of the TCU Horned Frogs had a great contest, great follow through. Maybe distracted.
The pass to Avery Anderson, he wasn't looking for it. Bounced off his chest into his hands. Timeout taken by the Horned Frogs.
A wild sequence right there. A
lot going on. They lead 64-60 over the Cats. 4:25 remaining. Right. Oh my God.
All right, I'll try to explain that again. Thomas got the steal and he was on a fast break, and Avery Anderson was contesting on him, falling through, chasing him down. He didn't get any contact on the ball. Looks like he may have just distracted. Thomas saw him in the corner of his eye and got a little scared. And then on the other end, when the Horned Frogs have it, they try to pass it to Avery Anderson. He wasn't ready for it. It hit him in the shoulder, and he was a little bit lost. Resulted in the Horned Frogs timeout.
They extended this one to a media timeout.
Should be the last one of regulation.
Leading scorer for the Bearcats is Day-Day Thomas with 14 points. Leading rebounder John Newman with 6. Day-Day Thomas also has 4 assists on the game, leading the Bearcats.
An interesting stat I want to point out is when I was prepping for this game, you know, we talked about TCU, you know, averaging 10 steals per game, which is 11th nationally, but then also they give up 12 turnovers a game. And tonight they have 9 steals, but also 16 turnovers. So it kind of contradicts itself. You know, this team as well shoots nearly 50% from the field and then 34% beyond the arc. But tonight, shooting 56% from beyond the arc of the Horned Frogs, when they came in with a three-point shooting percentage of 11th in the Big 12.
Out shooting the Bearcats from beyond the arc heavily. Bearcats only shooting 25%.
Yeah, and I believe at the half, when the Bearcats had 32 points, 20 of them came within the paint. And now when the Bearcats have 60 points, 42 of those points have come from the paint. So, you know, the Bearcats like driving in and feeding the bigs. And as Henry said, it's not really a guards game, or at least it wasn't at that point in the game.
Play about to resume outside the media timeout. Teams take the floor. It'll be Horned Frog basketball. They'll throw it in right in front of their own bench. You can feel the energy in Fifth Third Arena.
4:25 left to go. There have been some great games here. I mean, you got last Tuesday against Texas with a great atmosphere. Here against TCU, it looks like it's going down to the wire.
PV will throw it in for the Frogs. 17 on the shot clock. Gets it into Nelson. Nelson with it. His man falls to the floor. It was Miller. Gets back up, but now Nelson moves to his right. Gets it up to Miller up top. Over on the Fifth Third logo, now it's Tennyson. Cross court to PV. PV works down to the baseline. He's going to pull up with a jumper. It's no good. Rebounded by Day-Day Thomas. Kept it just in bounds. And he got it back into Newman. Now Thomas is going to carry it up the floor. Thomas with it now. Works it to his right. Stops for a second. Lets his offense develop. Now with his left. Pull up jumper. No good off the rim. Bounce around a couple hands. Foul is going to be called on Victor Lockin. It'll go in the Horned Frogs' favor.
You're going to have Bandigo check in. And Dreed's going to come out. So the Bearcats are going to go more with a bigger lineup with Lockin, Bandigo, Skillings alongside John Newman and Day-Day Thomas.
Warren Foggs will throw it in. Carry it up the court slowly. It'll be Jameer Nelson. Nelson across midcourt. Guarded closely by Day-Day Thomas. Backs him down. Gets it over to Peavy in the left side. Peavy now working towards the paint. Kicks it back outside to Tennyson up top. Who works it once again back to Nelson. Nelson towards the top of the key. 10 on the shot clock. Got to work a little faster. Pulled up. Picked up his dribble. Got it over to Coles. This three is no good. Lockin comes down with it. Bearcats have the ball. Here comes Day-Day Thomas. Thomas did a little move behind his back on his defender. Hands it off to Skillings. Skillings over to Newman. Newman up top to Bandego. Thought about going down low to Lockin. Picks up his dribble. Now gets to Skillings. Skillings on the right side. Cuts towards the baseline. Timeout will be called by Wes Miller. 30 seconds. Bandego still put up the shot and it went in. TCU on a scoring drought of 2 minutes and 17 seconds. Bearcats have a good chance here.
And the thing, with 3 minutes left to go, both teams with one timeout left, which is very critical, especially in an aspect like this, close game going down to the wire. You're going to need your timeouts, but only one left, 3 minutes left to go. It's going to be, it's going to be very critical.
We saw in that first half, Wes Miller had to take 2 within the first 6 minutes.
Yeah. He burned one when TCU was up like 7-2, and then they went on that big run, in which was just a shootout, and they called another timeout to try and calm things down. But yeah, Bearcats, one timeout left, 3 minutes to go. It's going to be interesting to see how this goes. So on the inbound, Bearcats are going to have 10 seconds left on the play clock, so not a lot of time to be messing around. Got to go through. I got to be serious.
Thomas tried to get it into Newman. It's knocked right back out of bounds. You're going to call a kickball on Miller. Do it. That resets the shot clock to 20.
Okay. Good observation.
Simons Lukosius now will throw it in for the Bearcats. Gets it up to Bandego. He went up and got it. Used his 7-foot frame, but he loses it. Trying to pass it back to Lukosius. Here come the Horned Frogs. Up with it. Bounces off a couple hands. No good. Back up with his Uday. No good. Bandego comes down with it. They're going to call a foul. Bandego was just moving back and forth, trying to get the foul, and they finally call it. Believe on Uday. Bandego's going to go to the line once again. He came down with a rebound with 2 guys on him. Almost throwing elbows there trying to get that foul.
Yeah, so once again, that ball was bouncing around the rim when the Horned Frogs had a fast break. Just bouncing around, fight for the rebound, putbacks are no good. Ends up in the hands of Bandego. Makes a great play after making a bad pass in the previous possession. Like you mentioned, him and Uday going at it, throwing elbows. But Bandego goes to the line, and the Bearcats are now in the double bonus with 2:51 left to go in the game.
Bandego throwing elbows off the rebound, taking one out of his assistant coach Jake Thielen's playbook there. Bandego's first shot is up, and it's no good.
Bearcats are shooting 50% from the charity stripe.
Lukosius comes out of the game for the Cats. Bandego grabs the ball, ready for his second shot. 2:51 remains. Bearcats still down 4. Shot is up. No good off the front of the rim. He goes for his own rebound, but can't get it. Tennyson comes down with it for the Horned Frogs. Come the Frogs. On the right side, it's Coles. Back up top to Nelson. Nelson backs down Day-Day Thomas once again. Slows down, milks the clock a little bit, lets his offense develop. There's Coles with it now. Just off the free throw line, over to Peavy on the left side on the wing. Peavy now works it to the right. He's going to back up all the way almost to midcourt.
Mismatch, he has Bandego on him.
Here he goes, driving inside to Peavy. Foul is going to be called on Bandego. Oh, he doesn't like that one.
He's telling his coach to review it. He's telling Wes Miller to review it. Here's a replay. We're going to look on the Jumbotron.
A little bit of contact. Regardless, Peavy's going to go to the line for 2.
He's a 59% free throw shooter on the year.
Student section comes alive. Peavy with the ball. First shot is up. No good off the back of the rim. Big miss from Peavy.
He's like too much on that one right there. Lukosius comes in for Newman. Bandego has 4 fouls, so he's going to stay in the game. I would suggest maybe Jameel Reynolds should come in for Vandega, get that physical aspect down beneath. But
PV ready for his second shot. It's up off the back of the rim. Once again, Vandega comes down with it. Bearcats within four, 2:20 remaining. Looking to get within one possession. Day-Day Thomas works to the right. Dan Skillings down low to Lockin. Lockin's shot is up and good. Victor Lockin gets the Cats within two. Here comes Fifth Third Arena to its feet. Horned Frogs looking for an answer. Trying to extend their lead. Up top, it's Nelson. Nelson makes a move on Thomas, works him to his right. He's wide open for the three. Takes the shot, no good off the back of the rim. Couple of hands go up for it, and it comes right back to his hands on the offensive board. Anderson just holding it on the CPAL logo.
13 left of the shot clock, so 10 seconds in action.
Works it to his right, works into the paint, shots up, no good. Bounce off a couple hands, back into his hands! Nelson once again with the offensive board. Peavy now with it inside the paint. Works around for a couple times. Now just in mid-range, it's Miller. Miller on Vandego, pulls up the jumper. No good off the back of the rim, but they come down another offensive board! Back up top, it's Tennyson. Works inside, Peavy, a minute 19 remains. And at top, it's Nelson again. Fans come alive, 8 on the shot clock. 1:10 remaining in the game. Nelson works to his left, cuts inside, pushes off his man, shots up, no good. Goes off the hands, I believe, of Lockin with 0.4 remaining on the shot clock. We'll see if they review this one.
Wes Miller's going to review. He's saying to the ref, he's going to review. From here, at least it looked like it went off Lockin's arm. But that possession, I mean, offensive rebounds for the Horned Frogs. I mean,
I'm out of breath after that one.
I mean, Cincinnati, one of the top rebounding teams in the nation. You know, they average 43 per game. That's eighth in the nation. They're losing the rebounding battle, 38-30 to the Horned Frogs. And the Horned Frogs average 39 rebounds a game, too. So they're neck and neck, but a horrible time for the Bearcats to be allowing offensive rebounds.
17 offensive boards for the Horned Frogs. Horned Frogs have 0 points in the last 418. 0 for their last 8, 1 for their last 10. It was a battle down low between Victor Lockin and Ernest Uday. From this review we're seeing, it's tough to see.
It is tough.
That's a rough angle if that's all they got. With how both teams started this game in the first 6 minutes, we thought we were going to have a triple-digit shootout. Both teams have slowed down tremendously, shooting 42% and 49% respectively.
I mean, everyone here in the first bowl is on their feet. You know, it's kind of tough to see the court, but everyone's standing up. You know, I got to look up a little bit, rise my chin up. It's hard to see. I mean, once again, though, here at Fifth Third Arena for the Bearcats, another game coming down to the wire. I mean, awesome.
This is our third straight Big 12 game for the Cats coming down to the wire. We mentioned this is their fourth of five consecutive ranked matchups to open up Big 12 play. Potential for six when we head to Lawrence, Kansas next week.
And I think that will be six unless something crazy absolutely happens. We saw Kansas lose at UCF earlier in the week. So
that wasn't a week where we saw an absurd amount of upsets.
I believe Oklahoma was top 10, and they lost, including, you know, they lost to TCU as well, and Houston lost.
TCU coming off two straight AP top 10 wins, beating Oklahoma and Houston.
So they start that off, and then they play three of their next four games on the road.
Whew. Referees still discussing at midcourt. They're off the monitor. 0.4 on the shot clock. If TCU has possession, the shot will have to go up immediately.
Ref's talking to Wes Miller, so based on the reaction we're about to get, we're going to see the call.
Kind of tough to take anything from that reaction. They put 0.9 now on the shot clock, so that tells us it's TCU ball still. It'll be an inbound underneath the basket. This shot will have to go up almost immediately.
So with the big bodies of Lockin and Bandego in the paint, yeah, we're going to expect a catch and shoot here
by the Horned Frogs. You know, keep an eye out for Emmanuel Miller.
Fifth third comes alive. Nelson's going to throw it in. Guarded by Bandego. He gets it up. Peavy loses possession. Shot clock violation. Bearcat basketball. 101 remains. The Cats down two.
Bearcats need a stop. They got their stop. Now they must answer on offense. 101 left to go in the game. This is the moment where we find out who that player is to take these clutch shots. In the last two games, it's been Lukasius. He had a good look against Baylor. He ended up taking the shot against Texas. But we'll see. Will it be Lukasius? We're about to find out. They had 2 seconds left as well, so it'll be 103.
Do you go to the hot hand of Day-Day Thomas?
I think that's a question, you know, Coach Wes Miller definitely took into consideration, especially in that break they had, that huddle. They definitely discussed this. And maybe it'll be Day-Day Thomas. Maybe you'll go underneath your, you know, reliable starter lock, and we'll see.
Thomas caught the ball. It gets to Skillings. Skillings now to Lukasius. Lukasius faked the jumper, now pushes to his left. Skillings up top. Fakes the move to his right, cuts to his left. Thomas, for three from the corner. It's good! It's good! 65-64, the Bearcats lead. 45 remains. Horned Frogs with it now. They're going to call a timeout. 40.5 remains. The Bearcats with a one-point lead over the Horned Frogs. Day-Day Thomas, we said, do you feed the hot hand? And they do.
You said it. I mean, the kid from Bishopville, South Carolina, transferring from Kilgore College, HBCU, coming to Cincinnati. He just hit the most clutch shot he's had in red and black.
15 points against Baylor, 17 now against TCU. Bearcats on a 7-0 scoring run over the last 4:23. Five for their last seven. TCU in response, no points in the last 4:41.
And you can just feel the energy. I mean, throughout the game, the energy has been incredible. Everyone's on their feet. You know, this school, this city deserves a home Big 12 win. Will this be the game? 40 seconds left, a lot of time. We'll see.
Justin on the Jumbotron is also my future roommate, Anesti.
Also a member of Bearcats Media. He'll be on the call for Saturday's game when the Sooners come into town. I mean, like you mentioned, Day-Day Thomas, 17 points. He's leading the team. This kid's playing with a tremendous amount of confidence. I mean, we've seen it when he's driving in, going against, you know, a 6'11 Ernest Uday, just throwing it off the glass. Corner three, catch and shoot. That is pure confidence right there.
They come out of the timeout. 40.5 remains on the clock. Bearcats lead 65-64. It'll be Horned Frog basketball with 25 on the shot clock. Fifth third is alive and electric. Can feel the energy building. Bearcats trying to get their first home Big 12 win. Here we go as play resumes. Ball is thrown into Avery Anderson. Goes across the CPAL logo as the fans come alive. Pass inside, gets it to Miller. Miller looking for an even deeper inside pass. He gets it outside to Tennyson, though. Back up top to Anderson. Anderson works to his right. Makes it back up top to Tennyson. Tennyson with the three. It was open. It's good. Tennyson with the open three. 23 seconds remain. They lead by two, 67-65. Here come the Bearcats. It's Day-Day Thomas once again. They're going to take the quick timeout. 18.4 remains. Horned Frogs lead by two.
What a shot by Travia Tennyson. I mean, at the right wing, fading away to catch and shoot. They give the Hypno-Toe the lead, 67-65. He leads his team with 15 points.
All from range.
All from range, exactly. Shooting 5-for-9 from the field, but like you just mentioned, 5-of-7 coming from beyond the arc. The Bearcats get the ball. 18.4 left. No shot clock.
We find the situation again. Who do you go to? Do you go back to Day-Day Thomas, the hot hand? Do you find yourselves with Simas Lukosius isn't even on the floor?
The thing is, against Baylor, with about 10 seconds left, Coach Miller, down one, drew up a play for a corner three-pointer to Lukosius. Down one,
10 seconds, he chose for a corner three. I don't think that'll be the case. I think the Bearcats will probably let the clock run down the 10 seconds, then we'll see some action. But I want to see some underneath in the paint, in the key. You know, you don't have to go for the win. But we've seen Wes Miller. He can be an aggressive coach. So
yes.
I say he should take it easy and try to find it underneath through a player reliable like Lockin. Or, you know, we've seen Day Thomas drive in with confidence and poise. But we'll see. We're about to find out.
Teams come out of the huddles. Bearcats will have the ball. It'll be thrown in on the far side, just off midcourt. 18.4 seconds remain. TCU leads it 67-65. Bearcats looking for their first home Big 12 win. Their third straight game coming down to the wire.
Here we go.
Dan Skillings will throw it in. Lukosius is on the floor. They get into Thomas just before the backcourt violation. Here comes Thomas, driving inside. He throws it up. It's good off the backboard.
All right, 12 seconds, but got to play defense.
Day Thomas once again put it in. 11 seconds remain. TCU takes it up. No timeouts. Here we go. This shot is up from Tennyson. No good off the backboard. It bats off a couple hands. Day Skillings comes down. Foul is called. Foul is called on the Horned Frogs. Skillings will go to the line for two.
PV can't believe it.
2 seconds remains on the clock. Skillings will go to the line for two shots. Couldn't write that one up if you're the Bearcats.
You can't. I mentioned it. We've seen Thomas drive in with poison confidence. What does he do? He drives in with that same poison confidence.
Same finger roll. Put it up and in off the backboard. Dan Skillings at the line. 2 seconds remain. Fifth third will go silent. First shot is up. Off the backboard. No good. Off the back of the rim. Ooh, Dan Skillings misses a big one there. He's 2 for 5 from the line tonight now. Needs this one to give the Bearcats the lead.
All right, here. If Skillings misses, TCU has no timeouts left. 2.2 seconds left, all right? So they're going to have to go and play fast tempo and get something going if Skillings makes it. If he misses it, we got overtime possibly.
Referees discuss for a second. For some reason, we have a pause. I'm not sure what is going on here. Ref is looking at the clock, maybe?
Yeah, I'll say maybe clock.
Wes Miller's going to gather his guys for a huddle.
Rightfully so. You know, you got 2 seconds left. This is a great time to talk about what to do on certain situations. It was on the foul, so I believe they were trying to determine who the foul was called on.
3.7 now on the clock. They added an extra minute, or not a minute, second and a half. Sorry, they did not add an extra minute. Dan Skillings at the line for one to give the Bearcats the lead. Skillings dribbles. Shot is up. That one's no good as well.
Offensive
foul is going to be called on Bandego.
He's out. He's
fouled.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
A disaster.
Bandego's going to foul out, going for the board. That'll also put the Horned Frogs at the line for a 1+1 with 3.2 to go. That was worst case possible for the Bearcats.
It'll be 1-1. It's going to be Ernest Uday, who shoots 50% from the line.
Uday is 1 for 1 from the line today. Fans letting the refs hear about it.
Let's just say the refs have not had a good time in Cincinnati this year.
No.
Especially on Tuesdays.
No. These crews will not be wanted back later in the season. Ernest Uday will go to the line for the Frogs. 3.2 remains. Game tied at 67.
Same thing. If he misses, Bearcats have no timeouts. This is a 1-1.
Uday's first shot. It's up. It's no good off the back of the rim. Uday comes down with it. Here we go. Dede Thomas, half court heave. Off the back of the rim. No good. We will go to overtime. Tied at 67. Whew. Oh, my God.
If he would have hit that, this roof would have blown up.
Oh, my. We might end it up on the court.
We might have. There might be shooters thrown around. Who knows? It would have been pandemonium here at Fifth Third, but from new territory, you know, the Bearcats are going in their second overtime game this year. The first one, I believe, was at Howard.
At Howard.
In December. They won that game. I believe they outscored Howard in overtime 7-2.
They did.
But once again, this is going to be a little different. First, it's conference play. Second, it's at home. You were on the road for that Howard game. You're in D.C. Now you're here. You have your student section. You have Fifth Third Arena. Use that to your advantage. We'll see how the Bearcats come out and play. It's me. There's going to be no Bandego, so we saw Reynolds come in. And he provides that physical aspect. I mean, 6'11", 275. You know, he's had 18 points and 9 rebounds and 3 blocks over his last 2 games and 39 minutes of action. He's cut 45 pounds since the summer, since he got here.
A quote from our fellow broadcaster, Chase: this is madness.
This is what it's about, though.
You wanted drama, we'll give it to you.
How fun is this? The gauntlet of the Big 12. Providing once again, it never misses. And it gets better next year when you add Arizona, Arizona State, Utah, and Colorado.
5 minutes on the clock. We are knotted at 67. The 19th ranked Horned Frogs come into Cincinnati, and the Bearcats don't let them leave easy.
So in the first 5 minutes of the game, it was 26-13. We thought it was going to be a shootout. End of regulation, 67 apiece.
Tipped in, one by the Horned Frogs. Here we go. Final five for the Horned Frogs. It was Miller, gets it to Uday. Now for it is Anderson. He works his way inside, back out to Tennyson. Over to the right side. Back up top, makes it to Uday. Uday finds the inside to Tennyson. Tennyson's pull-up jumper. No good. For the rebound, it's Newman, though. Here come the Cats. Simas Lukosis up the left side. Slows down for a little bit. Going to take a screen from Victor Locken. Worked inside for a sec, then cut it back outside of Thomas. Thomas cutting inside again. Newman with the corner three. It's good. John Newman the third with the three. Puts the Bearcats up by three, but here come the Frogs. The Frogs quick. It's put in quickly by Emmanuel Miller. Makes it a one-point game. Cats now with speed. They lose possession. Stolen away by the Horned Frogs. Quick play off the jump.
Tempo by both sides.
Horned Frogs with it now. Avery Anderson working to his left. Went inside for a sec. Outside to Peavy. To the right now it's Tennyson. Finds himself on the Fifth Third logo. Motioning his offense. Quarterbacking him around. Anderson up top. To his right. Now passes it to his left to Miller. Miller working inside on Lukosis. Miller's shot is up. Fouled on the way up. He'll go to the line for two.
So the only good thing I'll say about this is that the lineup the Bearcats have right now, none of them are in foul trouble.
Yes.
The most fouls a person has on the court is one.
Yeah.
And that's going to be Thomas, Newman, and Locke with one foul apiece.
Fans not a fan of that call. Understandably why. Not a lot of contact on from the coaches there. Miller ends up at the line, though. He's shooting two. Dribbles it. Shot is up. It's good. Game knotted at 70.
The thing to keep an eye out for, Avery Anderson the third. He has 4 fouls for the Horned Frogs, so one more and he's out.
Yep. Miller at the line for a second. The third is loud and into it. Shot is up and that's good too. That'll give the Horned Frogs those lead 71-70. 3:43 remains. Bearcats with it now. Dede Thomas carries it up the court slowly.
They're running more of a smaller lineup with Skillings in now that Bandego's fouled out.
Yep. Skillings with it up top now. Back to Thomas. Thomas to the right side to Newman in the corner. Newman works to the baseline, cutting inside, picks up his dribble, goes up with it, puts it in, 72-71.
You know, great confidence by John Newman driving in baseline, going the reverse layup. Headed three, the possession of a four. Five quick points in overtime.
Cats with the lead.
Newman.
Cats with the lead once again. They come alive. Blocked by Victor Lockin. Victor Lockin says, not in my house. Sends him back. It'll be an inbounds pass from the Horned Frogs.
Lockin gets a second block. What a more clutch time to get that block.
Frogs will throw it in. Gets it into Tennyson quickly. His pull-up jumper. It's good. Horned Frogs take the lead once again, 73-72. 3 minutes even remains in overtime. Day-Day Thomas slowly up the court. Gets across the CPAW logo. Works it to the left. Backs up a little bit on his defender. Gets it to Skillings. Back to Thomas. Works it to his right. Worked inside for a second. Locking up top for three. Now it's just short. No good off the front rim. Here come the Horned Frogs. Horned Frogs with the lead. Moving with speed. Whoa. A little bit of a double dribble. Matt got away with. Newman comes away with the ball. They're fighting for it down low. A little bit of a mess beneath the basket fighting for the ball.
And they're going to review it if potential flagrant on Newman.
Yeah.
Looks like both of them. It was Newman and I believe... Let's see. It was Newman and Peavy fighting for it, and I believe both of them took shots in the face. And they might get a flagrant on this one. I don't think they should call it because of the nature of the game. I mean, it's 2:38 left to go in overtime. Let's be real. It's Big 12 basketball. Both these teams want to win. This is a quad one win for the Bearcats if they can pull this one out. So obviously emotions are going to be high. I just think it's physical basketball. You know, I don't think there should be a flagrant or a technical call, but at the same time, I would not be surprised if there was one.
Newman was fighting for his life beneath the basket there.
And at 2:38 left to go in overtime, I mean, this game did not disappoint so far.
They came out swinging. We compared it to a Big 12 football game, like a shootout. But, man, they have lived up to the hype.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we were prepping, just looking. You know, both of these teams have high-scoring offenses.
Two fast teams,
yeah. You know, I'll say it for the fourth time probably to our new viewers that we have, but TCU... You know, one of the top scoring teams in fast breaks. You know, one of the top teams forcing steals and turnovers.
They're,
I mean,
the only team with 20-plus points off fast break points in a game. There's no one like them.
It's very unique because you'll see they have stats like that, you know, and then also, you know, they are 11th nationally with steals per game. But at the same time, they gave up 12 turnovers a game. Tonight, they have 18 turnovers. But they have 10 steals.
Entertaining basketball being played throughout the whole night. Referee's still reviewing this call beneath the basket.
And they only showed one replay up on the Jumbotron, so we can't get a look. We saw it once, and they're like, yeah, you guys are done with that.
I'm nervous about this call for John Newman's sake. A last-minute made sign of refs good call zero has been made in
like
the student section.
The erase marks. how quickly they wrote that.
Made by a dry erase board in the student section. Referees still discussing off the monitor now. Big call that could put TCU at the line, potentially. Potentially could put the Bearcats at the line, too, if we're...
Remember, the Bearcats are still in double bonus, and the Horned Frogs are in a single bonus at the moment. So that'll carry for the entire of overtime.
Still catching my breath from some of that's occurred here.
I'm still amazed at that Thomas half-court heave.
We saw Chick-fil-A for a year one on a half-court shot last week. He would have deserved it on that.
Oh, yeah. Still discussing. Now they convene.
TCU's medical staff went to the midcourt there. I don't think I've ever seen that one before.
He was talking to UC's medical staff. So one of the referees is going to the announcer's table where the ESPN Plus broadcast announcers are. So the call's officially been made. One ref goes to each coach. So one's with Jamie Dixon and one is with Wes Miller.
I'm not loving Wes Miller's reaction to what's being said to him, but we'll see.
And Jamie Dixon looks very calm in front of us. I mean, refs, I mean, the kids got school tomorrow. I mean, we got classes. I mean,
we got class.
People got to work tomorrow.
It's worth it to watch the end of this game.
So they're calling, they believe they called it jump ball. I saw the refs then go jump ball.
Okay. No flagrant.
If it's a jump ball, it should be Bearcats possession.
Newman is, it looks like it will be Bearcat basketball. Newman will inbound it to Dede Thomas.
So like I said, it was one of those situations where it could have been a flagrant, but I just think it's a physical basketball game, and it's a physical basketball play.
Dede Thomas takes up the floor for the Cats with 2:30 remaining. Works it to his left, takes a screen from Locken. Inside the arc, back out to Locken for three. Up and good! Victor Locken made me pause for a second, but sinks it and gives the Bearcats a two-point lead. 75-73, the Cats lead 2:10 to go. Horned Frogs with it. Miller inside the arc at the free throw line, working on Newman. Backs him down, loses possession for a second, regains it. Backing down Newman, puts the shot up, no good. They come down with the offensive board. Foul is going to be called on the Bearcats, though, on the floor. Doesn't matter. They'll go to the line for two, though, as it'll put them in the double bonus.
And we saw, and then the last few minutes of regulation in here, offensive rebounds for TCU are really hurting the Bearcats. I believe in that one possession before regulation ended, they had three or four offensive rebounds.
Micah Peavy at the line with a chance to tie it. 0-for-2 on the night from the line. He'll have two. First shot is up. That one's good. Gets him within one.
Horned Frogs are in double bonus right now. So both teams are in the double bonus. Any foul will send them to the line for two shots.
Peavy at the line for his second. Fifth third, making as much noise as possible. Shot is up. That one's good as well. He makes up for the two he missed earlier. 2-1 remains. TCU makes a couple substitutions. Uday comes out of the game. Bearcats will inbound the ball. Dede Thomas takes it up the court with 2 minutes to go. Game knotted at 75. Newman up top. Thought about getting to Skillings in the corner. Back up to Lukosis, though. Lukosis working to his right. Down low to Skillings. Skillings now on the post. Backing down his man. Shot is up. No good. Come down with the rebound is Emmanuel Miller for the Frogs. Here they come. The Frogs with a minute 40 to go. Up top, it's Jameer Nelson, as we've seen all game, quarterbacking his offense. Waits for it to develop, milking the clock a little bit, gets down to 15 on the shot clock. Dede Thomas now applies a little bit more pressure, knocked it away for a second. Nelson gathered it, though. Nelson inside the arc, cross-court pass to Miller. Miller with it now. Newman's going to steal it away. Newman now on the fast break. He's going to drive towards the basket. Goes up with it, the foul. No good. He'll go to the line for two.
So for John Newman, we know free throws have been a struggle for him. He's missed his last four free throws. He's 0-for-3 tonight. He missed the one that could have sealed the game against Texas. 1:18 left to go in a tie game. This is a perfect time to break that streak and regain that confidence if you are John Newman.
Newman 0-for-3 from the night. From the line, but he converts that one.
And that's his 19th point of the night. Him and Dede have 19 apiece.
Two huge production pieces for the Bearcats all season long came to play tonight. Newman at the line for a second. Can give the Cats a two-point lead with 1:18 to go. Shot is up, and that one's good as well. 77-75, the Cats lead.
Newman had a smile on his face, a sigh of relief.
Fifth Third Arena. It is alive and well. Jameer Nelson with it for the Frogs. Tight pressure from John Newman on him. Gets it over to Coles at the top of the key. Works it to his right, back to his left now to Tennyson. Timeout taken by the Horned Frogs. 59-28 remains. They trail by two.
Right there, great defense by the Bearcats. And in overtime, each team gets one timeout. So with 59.8 left, Corn Frogs have no more timeouts, and the Bearcats still have their one timeout left in their pocket. This game did not disappoint. And if I'm not mistaken, at the moment, this is our most viewed basketball game on Bearcats Radio.
Shout out everyone watching from all over the country.
Shout out everyone watching.
Fans hoping to witness an historic game. The Bearcats getting their first Big 12 victory at home. Potentially another quad one win over a top 20 opponent. 11 seconds on the shot clock for the Horned Frogs to inbound. It'll be Micah Peavy in front of his own bench. Fifth Third Arena, as loud as it has been all night. Here come the Frogs. Nelson with it once again at the top of the key, working to his left. Six on the clock, working inside at the free throw line. He's guarded by Locken. Inside the paint, goes up with it. It's good. Jameer Nelson once again.
What a great finish by Jameer Nelson. Going down on Locken, throwing it up. The floater makes it fall.
Day-Day Thomas with it now. 40 seconds remain. Timeout will be taken exactly at 40 seconds remaining with 20 on the shot clock. We are knotted at 77. Bearcats with the timeout. Cool. They're trading off back and forth.
Right here at this moment, last time we saw Day-Day Thomas hit the corner three and to tie the game up, he drove in with confidence and poise. There's 20 seconds left. We'll see what Coach Miller decides what to do. Will it be Thomas driving in again? Will they go to the all-reliable Victor Locken? We'll see. We're about to find out.
Do we go to leading scorer, John Newman? 20 on the night.
As I mentioned before, you know, we still have yet to find out who that person is in those clutch moments. And in honesty, on the court right now, I see five of them.
Yep.
Any one of those guys, Lukasius, Locken, Newman, Thomas, or Skillings can take that shot. Lukasius has had a quiet night, 7 points, 2 for 6. Will it be him? Will it be Dan Skillings? We'll see.
I've said it multiple times, but Fifth Third Arena providing one of the best atmospheres in the Big 12, and they're just proving it tonight. Pass goes in to the backcourt to Day-Day Thomas. He's working to his left, 14 on the clock, just outside the arc. He's guarded closely by Tennyson. Up top is Lukosis, 10 on the shot clock, working to his left. Finds Skillings. Skillings was open for three passes on it. Works inside. Finger roll up and in. Dan Skillings gives the Cats the lead, 79-77.
No shot clock. This is it.
17 seconds remain. Here come the Frogs. Down two. Up top. The three was faked by Coles. He's going to take that one. It's no good off the back of the rim. Day-Day Thomas with the rebound. He's fouled. He'll go to the line for two.
Thomas, an 80% free throw shooter, but great defense by the Bearcats. So Jacoby Cole, who thought about it, hesitated multiple times and finally shot it too much off the back iron. And Thomas, 6 foot, probably the smallest guy on the court, ends up with a rebound.
Day-Day Thomas, he's been your guy all night.
He has been.
Comes down with a big rebound with 5.9 to go. Bearcats with the chance to make it a two-possession game and all but seal this one.
So if Thomas misses the second one, Horned Frogs have no timeouts. They have to go.
Thomas's first shot is up and it's good. Gives the Cats an 80-77 lead. 5.9 remains. This next free throw is big. Cats have cleared the lane. Horned Frogs will have every chance at an offensive board or a defensive board if it's missed.
They have Josh Reed in for defensive purposes right here.
Thomas with the ball now. Fifth Third Arena goes quiet. His shot is up. That one's good. The Cats take a 4-point lead with 5.9 to go. Fifth Third Arena is about to come alive. The pass is up. It's caught. Three is up for Miller. That's no good. The Bearcats are going to get their first Big 12 home victory over the TCU Horned Frogs. And here come the fans.
Storming the court. They waited all year, and they finally get their home Big 12 win. They lost a heartbreaker against Texas. They lose arguably another heartbreaker against Baylor over the weekend, and here they are, finally.
The Bearcats get their second top 20 win of the season, defeating the 19th-ranked TCU Horned Frogs, and it's a scene at Fifth Third.
You know, it's 90s night. Today, it was a good day.
There's the 90s reference we've been waiting for. What a game.
This game did not disappoint.
Big 12 basketball. The Cats are welcoming themselves into the conference with open arms. They said they belong here, and they're showing it. Oh, my God. The Bearcat is crowd surfing.
I mean, this is
an all-time moment.
It's incredible. This is definitely a moment, you know, these students will remember. These fans, too. I mean, this game is going back and forth. I mean, we said it earlier. We thought it was going to be a shootout earlier. You score 39 points in the first 5 minutes combined. Then they slow down. At halftime, it was 33-32.
Oh, my God.
We got overtime.
Fifth Third comes alive for one last time tonight to celebrate their Bearcats.
In the overtime period, the Bearcats scored 14 points in pair to the Horned Frogs.
Oh, my God.
10 points.
I don't know what to say right now. I'm stunned.
You know, I felt the same way last Tuesday, but stunned in the opposite way. We were stunned that Max Asemus became a villain once again in the state of Ohio. And now tonight, we're stunned because we just witnessed a great game. And these fans will remember this game for a very, very long time.
Fans begin to clear off the court. I guess we start to wrap this one up. I mean, it's...
Where do we start?
Let's see. I know where I'm going to start. Day-Day Thomas. 21 points, the Bearcats' leading scorer. Once again in double figures, he had 21, 6 assists and 4 rebounds in 33 minutes on the court. What a night, I mean, Day-Day Thomas.
When you look at it, the end regulation, he had the catch-and-shoot corner three-pointer. He made that. He drove in with confidence and poise to tie the game up. He had the clutch free throw. So when I said the three-pointer was probably his biggest shot in red and black, I lied. I'd probably say, you know, those free throws the layup that sent it to overtime, but overall, a great performance by Day-Day Thomas.
Alongside him with 20 points was John Newman. He also had 7 boards and 2 assists. Also for the Bearcats with 13 points, Dan Skillings. He had 6 rebounds with 2 assists to go along with it. Also in double figures was Victor Locken with 11.
And when you say 11 points for Victor Locken, 5-for-6 from the field. He had that clutch three,
night.
I believe, in overtime, too.
He did. He pulled up multiple times in overtime and came up with the second one. That was a big shot. He made me pause in midair when that shot. Wasn't sure what to say about it as it arced its way in there. But
high-arcing three-pointer.
Locken made it when he had to. Looking at the visiting team, the TCU Horned Frogs, that came away just short. Tennyson with 17 points for him. He was 5-for-8 from beyond the arc. What a game from deep for him.
Tennyson was just hitting three-pointers, fading away left and right. I mean, he came to this game averaging 8 points, and he dropped 17, shooting 6-for-12 from the field. And like you mentioned, 5 three-pointers as well.
Also with 15 for the Horned Frogs was Emmanuel Miller, and with 13 was Jameer Nelson.
You look at Avery Anderson. I mean, he came to this game averaging 10 points a game, the transfer from Oklahoma State. Tonight, the Bearcats held him to 3 points and 6 turnovers. He had more turnovers than points.
We're high-fiving fans as they walk past us to the exit.
We don't know how to act, all right?
This is a moment that we're going to remember for years to come. The Bearcats get their first Big 12 home victory, their second top 20 win of the season. When that next AP poll comes out, what is it going to look like?
I mean, I don't know.
Can the Bearcats find themselves in there?
Hey, they have another ranked matchup against Oklahoma, so we'll see. We'll be there Saturday, 1 o'clock. Justin and I, as he's right in front of us, throwing up fours. But an interesting stat I'll say real quick. The Bearcats, out of their 81 points, 50 points in the paint. Talk about controlling the paint and the key.
Ooh, the Bearcats, just historic win. Don't know what else to say.
And when you look at the Bearcats, they are a notorious great rebounding team this year, you know, averaging 43 rebounds per game. Tonight, they lost the rebounding battle 41-35.
They did.
And they still ended up with the win.
Did win the turnover battle, though, 19-15 in their favor, which coming into the game, we knew was going to be a big deal. But Bearcats come away on top with it all. With that, the final score of Bearcats 81, TCU Horned Frogs 77. Win in overtime. My name's Aiden Riggs.
I'm Christian Pagan.
We're signing off.